Sunday afternoon, and I'll try to keep you awake. But before that, can I ask you to close your eyes for a few minutes? A few seconds, sorry. Few seconds. Can you close all of your eyes, please, for a few seconds?
आंख अगर चली गई तो मैंने क्या करना है, रोज के काम में तो मुझे दिखता ही नहीं ना, लिखने की लिखते नहीं आ रहे हैं और पढ़ते नहीं आ रहे हैं। अब जब दिख ही नहीं रहा तो मुझे तो लगा कि मेरी ज़िंदगी पूरी समाप्त हो गई है, अभी अभी अपने को कुछ करना ही नहीं है, बिल्कुल टोटली पैरालिस हो गया अपन।
कई बार तो ऐसा लगता था मुझे कि मुझे सिर्फ 5 मिनट के लिए कोई अपनी आँखें दे दे, भगवान बस सिर्फ 5 मिनट के लिए दे दे और मैं देख लूँ सारी चीज़ें, अपनी बेटी को देख लूँ।
Seeing, I had a completely clear sight. It was unbelievable.
And what he said once is that sometimes I just close my eye to enjoy the marvelous improvement in the left eye. I am very grateful that a stranger in India supported an unknown patient from Netherlands, and my life had changed after coming to India. And you know what he does now? He has started his business here in India in 3 cities. And comes for a checkup every 3 months and visits the business sites. So these things make big impact in people's lives. This gentleman, who's an Indian Gujarati living in Canada, had just graduated as an engineer, got married, and suddenly, because of an accident, lost both his eyes. And next 40 years, he has lived in doubt, tried every sort of treatment in North America, could not find a solution, again landed up in Hyderabad, looking for a treatment. And his daughter flew in from Switzerland to donate the tissue for growing and treating his father. Then, after 40 years, we did the surgery and did a corneal transplant. When he opened the eye, can you imagine the mix of emotions he must have after 40 years of seeing the wife, the daughter, and the grandkids for the first time? And suddenly, he could relate with all the words, the voices that he has been hearing, with the pictures that he is seeing now. Almost like an excitement of the child who sees an IMAX movie for the first time, that was a 3D movie. So again, these kind of changes are transformational, and what you see in people's life makes a huge difference. And ever since he has been seeing well, and he continues to see well on one eye, the other eye he could not see. The success is not permanent. The failure is not better, it's the courage to continue that counts. My friends, about 30 years back, I could not get into an engineering college or a medical college because I had MPC plus biology. And I failed to get into a medical college or an engineering college in my first attempt. I was so frustrated that I'm not going to be either of them. I joined the physics honors in Delhi University, and I said, go to hell, I'm just be a different kind of a field. The next year, 3 idiot kind of moments happened to me. Friends, family, everybody said, no, 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 you should try once more, at least once more. Be a doctor, you know, there's no one in the family. I did try and go into the medical college in 1982, and on this Haryana Roadways bus, you can maybe support me. This used to be the usual mode of journey from college to the home, which is a small village in Haryana, Bhiwani district, and used to go and help my parents to do the family work in the fields. The life in a college, whether it's engineering or medical college, is those 4 years are absolutely fabulous, fantastic. Believe me, that is the best part of your life. Why it is best? Because you don't have to worry about anything. Because the amount of excitement and enjoyment you have is fantastic. Only it is interrupted by occasionally by exams. Otherwise, you don't have to worry about anything else in life. All of us were told that once you get an engineering college and or a medical college or a professional college, life, your life is set. But please listen and pay attention to what I'm going to tell you. The life actually begins. The problems are only after that. It's not the solution of the problems. So we, 4.5 years, happy rolling, parties, fancy dress shows, and everything, life was fantastic. Suddenly at 4 years, in the medical, you become a doctor and you become an intern. So I become an intern. The first day I was posted in a nursery or a neonatal care unit where I have no idea what I'm supposed to do. I had no training, I just read theory, I had no practical experience. And that night I saw 3 infants dying in front of me. Next 2 days I could not sleep. I was so disturbed. I said, this is not correct. What is the point of having a medical degree if I can't treat somebody who's dying in front of me? So I was so agitated, I told one of my friends, I said, look, I'm giving up, I don't want to be a doctor. See, there's no point being a doctor if you can't treat people. He said, no, it's okay. He said, no, now the degree is not enough. Now we have to prepare for PG entrance. I said, then what's the point of having MBBS? Neither you can treat, nor you can get a job. He said, at least you can get married, you can find a wife. At least you are slightly better than the other people. Well, that's at least something that you can achieve. So finally he said, okay, now we are, intensive, we have to start preparing for PG intensive, yeah. And I said, what to do PG intensive? How do you decide what subject you want to do? He said, well, prepare for exams and enter, appear for entrance, and then we decide. I said, but you should know what you're going to do. He said, no, this doesn't how it works. The way it works is that you get into the merit, and based on that, you decide. So we had appeared for the entrance exam. Unfortunately or unfortunately, I was the topper of that entrance exam, and I wanted a branch called eye or ophthalmology, which was the least or not anything at that time. Nobody wanted to get in there. So I said, I want to be an eye doctor. They said, you must be crazy. Why should you want to be eye doctor when you are a topper, going to medicine, going to orthopedics? These are the money generating branches. I said, but I like ophthalmology. He said, you must be stupid. You must be really crazy. My professor even said to the extent, agar tune eye kiya to kamarega. I said, I'm so serious. What should I do? I turned, I went to my village, I talked to my father, and what he said? I told him my problem, he did not understand much. He said, do what you think is good for you and excel in it. And I just did not understand much. I said, okay, I'm going to do ophthalmology. And why I wanted to do is, I said, look, this eye is very small. You don't need too much of instruments. And you can start a private practice. There's nothing much in it. So it was so straightforward. So I then started doing residency. This is 3 years again. And during the residency, what you do? You see patients, you do some surgery. But by the time you finished 3 years, the kind of skills that we had was not anything great. I was told that with these skills you can't start a private practice. I said, what do you mean? 8.5 years now, and I can't start a private practice? He said, no, with this how you can? The technique what you acquire is not good enough. So I started looking for a fellowship. But by then there was another complication. I was married. And I was not only my decision. So I told my wife, I want to look for this. She said, we are not married for 1 year. I must be crazy. I said, no, but otherwise how will you earn money or how will you live a life? She said, I don't care, you decide. I said, look, if I don't do now, it will be now. So let me go this time only for 1 year. She said, okay. So we both tried and finally she agreed, okay, fine, you go. So I come to M.P. Prasad Eye Institute, did a 1 year cornea fellowship, and then one of the professors in the morning class announced that there is a fantastic plane which goes around, and I started dreaming about, oh, plane, this is a good idea to travel. So I called my wife again, and I said, you know, there is a, this kind of plane which goes and I can go around the world. She said, you must be mean. How you can even think about it? I said, I'm just thinking. I'm not saying I'm going. I'm asking, can I go? Oh, she said, okay, that's fine. She put the phone down. I said, okay, that's fine. 3 days later, after she must have discussed, and she called me back. Yeah, yeah, I think it's a good thing for both of us. You join. So I joined all this, went around the world 2.5 years, saw the world, saw the ophthalmology of the world. And finally, again, I told her that, look, I really want to go to Harvard. You know, I have been to research, and I have not learned research after so many days. And she said, no, you are not going. I said, I'm not going, but we'll go together. She said, yes. So make sure when you go for visa, I'll go with you. And I told her, I said, yeah, yeah, it's fine. But I said, but first I'll go and, no, we go together. I said, oh, fine. So we went together, I got the visa for every month, I went home. Did the, started working, doing research, and I started telling my friends there. I said, you know, I'm going to go back. He said, yeah, yeah, America will go be after, I said, both have office on that. Nobody goes back. So after 2 years, I started winding up. And then I said, I'm going. He said, you must be a dog. I said, yeah, obviously I am. I am a dog. He said, no, mentally you must be a dog. Oh, I said, okay, whichever way I am, I'm going back. But I did not come to stay here, so I'm anyway going. So what I have been doing is I started from Haryana, then Hyderabad, Harvard, then back to Hyderabad in 1998. And I hope my life cycle will complete someday in the next few years going back to Haryana. But I came back in 98 in L.V.P.E.I. Institute, started seeing kind of patients which are some of those patients with the sounds you heard, the pictures you've seen, that nothing can be done. And in our medical parlance, people or doctors say that it's best left alone. Best left alone. And this word I hate. I had the same those patients, I started having the same feeling which I had as an intern. I said, this is not acceptable. There must be some solution for these patients. So I started talking to one of my friends who is a pathologist, and I said, you know, I read about something about substances and they can be treated. You know, patient, there's a paper in Lancet that there's an Italian lady who has published that two patients treated by taking a biopsy from the normal eye, grow in the lab, transplant. She said, these things are good for paper. My friend, they are not good for, you know, India. These things don't grow here. I said, why not? Then I started talking to my other colleagues. They said, listen, Virender, you just came, start seeing normal patients, don't dream about all this stuff. It doesn't work. And I am just not able to reconcile as to why it should not work.
Our body is made up of cells, muscle, heart, skin. But most individual cells are short-lived, lasting only a few days or weeks. The job of stem cells is to divide and differentiate into these different tissues, replacing the old cells as they die off. They form the stem that produces all the cells the body needs. Stem cells keep renewing themselves. They provide us with a constant flow of new cells every day.
Do you know that every day, all of us, everybody, every human being makes about 20 billion red blood cells alone? Forget about the white blood cells. Our body is made up of about 20 trillion cells, and we harbor about 100 trillion bacteria in our body. We are just walking bioreactors. We make everything, we harbor everything. So, and we renew almost all our organs every few years. So, finally what we started doing in the cells and work, we started growing. We didn't ask in the hospital anything. We said, we'll just do what we can. And finally, in about 1 year, we could grow the cells, the corneal stem cells in the lab, and we are ready to transplant. Again, there was a problem. we could grow only one layer of cells, and generally it is 5 layers. What is written in the journal is 5 layers. So my colleagues of hormones can, you can't take to the patient. I said, listen, patients are mine, they trust me, I'm going to use them. If I can't benefit, I won't harm them. So therefore I'm going to use monolayer. And all over the world at that time, I was criticized in every meeting. They said, how you can use monolayer? Everybody else has used multilayer. I said, how does it make a difference? If it's working, it's working. So in my patient, it's working. And today, after 10 years, it has become a standard of care. It's the protocol which is followed globally. And we have the world's largest series of stem cells for any government anywhere in the world. Thank you very much.